Yeah, my name is Arjun J. Rao. I'm 19 years old. Different people are at different levels of spiritual level and refinement and understanding. I think Islam is for people who are already quite advanced at the spiritual understanding. Not everybody can follow its teachings meaningfully. Comparing it to a school, I mean, people are like at first standard, second standard, and at 10th. Islam is like 9th standard curriculum. So am I right that Islam is only for those who are already spiritually advanced?
Brother asked a very good question, that when we compare all the religions, Islam is at a higher level, advanced level. Like in a school, the other religions may be kindergarten, first standard, Islam is 9th and 10th, the higher level. Is he right? I do agree with you. Agree as well as disagree. Agree that yes, Islam is for those who are spiritually high. But that does not mean a person who's not spiritually advanced, he cannot enter Islam. I disagree with that. Why? Because normally for everyone, anyone who enters school, if he enters English school, the first thing he learns is what? He learns the alphabet of that language. Suppose he's entering school, which is English medium school, in nursery, he will learn A, B, C, D, correct? So in Islam, even if a person is not spiritually high, when he enters school, the minimum he should follow is Tawheed. The basic ABCD of English language is comparable to Tawheed of any religion. Tawheed means believing in one God. So what I was describing earlier when our Sikh brother asked the question about the concept of God, that is the basic. And that basic is present in every religion. But unfortunately, those people who are the religious leaders, they don't want people to follow that. Because if they follow that, who will follow the religious leaders? If everyone starts worshipping one God, then all these religious leaders will not be required. There's no intermediary required. In all the other religions, you require intermediary. A pandit, a priest, a guru. Here it is direct between you and your creator. So all the religions have the same basic message, which is there in Islam. But unfortunately, the religious leaders, they don't want their followers to know this. They want to keep them away, because if they enter the school, finally they will submit their will to God. Submit their will to God means become Muslim. And then these intermediaries, they will lose their job. You know, they'll have to close their shops down. So that's the reason. Otherwise, all the religious scriptures, even though they have been changed, Almighty God, He got only one religion for all the human beings. But by the passage of time, the scriptures kept on changing. Even after the scriptures have changed, there have been interpolations, there have been fabrications, there have been concoctions. Yet, in the remnants of all the religious scriptures, you find the message of Tawheed, of one God, that idol worship is prohibited. You worship Him. There may be other contradictory remarks also. But if you search for the truth, and you find, so what I say, irrespective, the moment you realize that there's a creator, which I shall discuss tomorrow in detail, then you realize what is the purpose of your life. And then the initial nursery and the kindergarten of every spiritual aspect, every religion is believe in one God and He alone deserves worship. So anyone who's not even spiritually advanced, the moment he wants to thank his creator, he submits his will. And a person who submits his will, he's called as a Muslim. Hope that answers the question.
Yes, brother.
I am from Karnataka, Hubli. I am doing job, a manager as a medical distributor. My question is, where is dead one? What happened to them? Thank you.
Brother asked the question, where are the dead people and what has happened to them? As I mentioned in my earlier answers, that Allah says in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata, that Almighty God has created death and life to test which of you is good indeed. So this life is the test for the hereafter. Now once a person dies, his test is over. Test is finished. But the results of all the human beings, from the first human being on the face of the earth, from Adam, peace be upon him, till all of us that are living, as well as till the last human being going to live, all will be resurrected on the day of judgment. And the results will be declared together. You know how we have, for example, here we are voting. voting takes place in North India separate date, South India separate date, East India separate date, but the counting starts together and the results are declared together. So similarly here, this test has taken place, but the Malik Yawmuddin, he is the master of the Day of Judgment. The Day of Judgment will be together. Hisab Kitab, who's right, who's wrong, will take place together. And then depending upon your good deeds or bad deeds, have you obeyed the commandments of Almighty God or not, you may go to heaven or hell. So all of us would be resurrected. At present, they are dormant. Dormant, that means they have died, but they'll be resurrected. Almighty God will give them life again on the Day of Judgment. So all the human beings will be resurrected. And on the Day of Judgment, Allah says in the Quran, that no one would object to the justice of Almighty God. Because our organs will be our witness, our eyes will give witness, our hands will give witness about ourselves. So even those who will be put in hell, if they have not followed the commandments, the Quran says, they will not object to the justice of Almighty God. They will say, give us one more chance, and Almighty God will say, it is too late. The exam is over. So on the Day of Judgment, all be resurrected, depending upon the good deeds, bad deeds. You will pass or you will fail, you will go to heaven or hell. Hope that answers the question, brother.